price point. For starters, a very decent hardware. Compared to last year's Note 7 predecessor, the Snapdragon 665 chipset was manufactured in the 11 nanometer production process instead of the usual 14 nanometers. This means better energy efficiency, but oddly enough, because of the slightly lower clock speeds on its faster cores, the new Snapdragon 665 has slightly lower performance than the older 660 chipset. Both versions rely on 4-fast Cryo 260 Gold Cortex A73 and 4 slower Cryo 260 Silver Cortex A53 cores. While the slower cores in both versions are clocked at 1.8 GHz, the older Snapdragon 660 has 4 cores at 2.2 GHz and the newer Snapdragon 665 at only 2 GHz. Realistically, performance differences are only measured in synthetic tests, and we all know how unreliable they are when it comes to smartphones. In real use, there isn't much difference. It's a mid-range chipset and it performs as such. It's fast enough that you won't feel any issues in regular use, though Snapdragon 665 does show its weaknesses under extreme loads. Reason for this may also be due to RAM memory, as the phone comes with 4 GB of RAM, which is on the bottom limit for decent performance. Thanks to the decent OS optimization and fairly well-optimized MIUI user interface, the Note 8T offers a very good user experience in everyday use. It comes with 64 GB of storage with just under 50 GB that are user available, though you can expand the storage capacity by adding a microSD card. Even better news is that the SD card does not take up your second SIM slot, unlike the usual hybrid dual SIM system we often see these days on phones. The large 6.3-inch screen makes for a very comfortable use, even if you split the screen with two applications. Full HD Plus resolution offers a lot of workspace, and MIUI provides 6 levels of interface font size adjustments, from extra small to extra extra large. The IPS matrix has faithful color rendering and covers 84% of the NTSC spectrum, while the density of 409 pixels per inch guarantees a very sharp image. The screen has a teardrop notch and rounded screen corners. The bezels are noticeable, especially on the bottom side, and the body size has been expertly concealed by an additional bezel slightly raised above the surface. In this way, a step transition is made between the surface of the case and the screen, making the screen to body ratio appear to be a lot more than just 80.2%, which is only average in today's terms. The notch is not that noticeable and hides a selfie camera, while the light and proximity sensors are located on the left of it and are visible only on a very bright day. The color we got to test is the most visually dull space black, while the Neptune blue and Nebula purple look very attractive with a nice gradient of the screen bezels. The sandwich design of the Note 8T hides a bulky, rounded plastic frame between two flat glass surfaces. The contrast between the flat surface of the screen and the back at the curved lines on the side look unconventional for a lower middle class phone. The design does have its downsides as well, as it might be easier to accidentally drop the phone, so we recommend using a protective case. Good news is that the silicone case comes in the package, and it fitted so that it levels the camera module with the back. If you do not use a protective case, the first thing to touch any surface when you put your phone away will be its cameras. Since Xiaomi does not state whether it uses sapphire glass to protect the cameras, and the camera module is quite pronounced, we think that using the case from day one would be a good idea. Apart from the Redmi logo on the lower left corner and some inscriptions on the opposite side, the only element on the back is a miniature fingerprint scanner. Although the small size and the position closer to the top of the device have proven to be ripe for a poor performance, in this case, it's quite the opposite. Yes, it will take some time to get used to the location of the sensor, but after 2 or 3 attempts, everything will fall into place. Small dimensions act as a limiting factor, but they eliminate any doubt with very accurate performance and quick response. On the left side of the device, you will find the card slot, while on the right, there are power and volume buttons, which are placed closer to the upper edge. On the bottom, there is a 3.5mm audio connector, a microphone, a USB-C 2.0 port, and a mono speaker. On the opposite side, there is another microphone, and next to it is an IC blaster, which shows all of its power when paired up with an excellent Mi Remote application. Unfortunately, the Redmi Note 8T does not come with any IP certification, but we can confirm that it is resistant to small water spillage. please don't ask us how we know this. As for the cameras, this model also uses the popular pixel binning technology. Redmi Note 8T is equipped with Samsung's 0.8 micrometer ISOCELL Bright GM2 sensor, which has 48 megapixels, introduced early in May this year, along with GM1 version of 64 megapixels. The biggest advantage of the new Samsung sensor is the dual conversion gain technology, which converts receiving light into electrical signal according to the ambient light. This way, the sensor uses the collected light more efficiently, especially when there's enough light. According to Samsung's research, this results in sharper images than what's enhanced phase focus can offer. The main camera on the Redmi Note 8T smartphone has 0.8 micrometer pixel on the aforementioned sensor, with a maximum aperture of f1.8. Pixel fusion technology allows recommended recordings at 12 megapixels, as well as the full sensor resolution, which is 48 megapixels. The wide-angle lens, which is the first one on the back of the device, covers an angle of 120 degrees, and behind it is the 8-megapixel f2.2 aperture sensor. Next in line is the 2-megapixel depth sensor and a macro camera with f2.4. On the software side, we find the standard Xiaomi camera app with its specific navigation and not too detailed options. For example, image quality selection option gives high, medium, and low options without further explanation what each of them actually mean. On the other hand, there are other useful features that tilt shift, built-in QR code recognition, and adjustment that eliminates light source flickering when recording videos. In use, the Samsung sensor produced pretty good results, given the price category the phone belongs to. In bright sunlight, the pictures are quite crisp, with precise colors and good dynamic range, even when not using HDR. The amount of details is satisfactory for the class to which the phone belongs, as well as the very low noise level. Where the sensor results start to decline is the advertised face focus. We notice that even in good lighting, the focus point may miss the subject, especially if it's moving. Even the smallest gestures can confuse the Note 8T main sensor, so you'll often get blurry photos of children, animals, and anything that refuses to stand still when you take a picture. This is even more pronounced as the lighting dims due to lack of physical stabilization, so make sure you hold the phone firmly with as little movement as possible. Raising the resolution to 48 megapixels doesn't help the image quality. Actually, quite the contrary. The images are not sharper and you will not see more details. Plus, it will take a few seconds for the image to be saved on the internal memory. On the other hand, the wide-angle camera is a pleasant surprise. The pictures are very fine, rich in detail, but with less dynamic range and slightly more pronounced noise. The software automatically performs lens correction, which can be manually switched off, but there is no need for this, as the impact is rather minimal. When it comes to the macro sensor, do not expect spectacular results, because it's more of a marketing gimmick than a camera that will make a serious difference and make you want to buy a phone just for that. The 2 megapixel limitations are visible, but we expected that. Unfortunately, the sharpness is not high, both in the corners and in the middle of the frame, so the usability of this sensor in real conditions is quite questionable. Low light photography is quite good, especially considering the price range it belongs to. Strong light sources, such as street lighting, can be a challenge and make the phone not perform very well. But if you carefully plan your shots, you can make very usable photos. Night mode is not so good and requires a very calm hand for at least 2 seconds, plus twice as much to save the image, so we recommend using the regular mode. Double zooms are done digitally, so the results are as they are expected, with some noise during the day and almost unusable after the sunset. So you should avoid using it, as it's better to capture the whole frame and then just crop the photo. The 13 megapixel fixed focus selfie camera has an f2.0 aperture and makes solid photos, with plenty of detail and accurate skin tone. The dynamic range and colors are also at a high level. Fixed focus is set to a little closer, so if you have longer arms, try not to keep your phone too far away in order to keep your face in focus. Like all modern phones, 4K is a must-have when it comes to video recording. The price of 4K TVs is almost equal to 1080p competitors, so shooting in Ultra HD is completely logical. You can record in 4K with 30fps, while in 1080p it can do 60 frames per second, but only with the main camera. The maximum wide-angle camera can also do 1080p at 30 frames per second. 4K shots are mediocre, with good color reproduction and contrast. Somewhat more aggressive software noise reduction is present and affects the quality of the recording, Above all, the dynamic range and level of detail. Unlike photos, video is average, and the situation doesn't change much when you go to 1080p. Electronic stabilization is only present at 1080p at 30 frames per second, and there is a noticeable difference in quality, especially if you're moving while recording. Slow motion capture is available in 120 frames per second for 1080p or 720p, or 240 FPS for 720p. While the maximum for macro cameras is 720p and 30 frames per second. The supply charger is rated at 18 watts, which means that you will charge your 4000 mAh battery in an hour and a half, and depending on the usage, you can count on a day or day and a half of battery life. Redmi Note 8T comes with MIUI version 10, which has been presented for almost a year and a half, but it was announced that the MIUI 11 is arriving any day now. It's possible that Xiaomi is waiting for a new version of the Android OS to launch the MIUI 11 on Android 10. As is the case with Mi Note 10, MIUI 11 runs on Android 9 OS. All the Redmi Note 8T offers far exceeds the price of $240. There are a few smartphones that offer Gorilla Glass 5 protection in this price range, especially the front and the back. A large number of connections is a plus that should not be overlooked, as in a pretty good camera that will handle most environments. When you add great autonomy, fast charging, and high quality software, the shortcomings such as mediocre video performance and slightly slower hardware than the previous generation don't seem that important. Redmi Note 8T has been carefully designed and gives a great deal of attention, especially the blue and purple versions that use some additional design tricks. Now, this is not a phone that you will buy for looks, only to be disappointed with the performance or vice versa. While creating the phone, Xiaomi made careful decisions about various aspects of it, providing good hardware base, appealing design, and attractive price. What more do you need, actually? My name is Marco, you were watching another Bench House review. See you next time. Till then, subscribe to our channel and like our video. See you next time.